Do not attempt the training techniques you are about to see without consulting a professional. Tonight, on Cesar 911, a once peaceful community is torn apart by a German shepherd that is out of control.
Tasi goes from zero to explosion.
She's bit my daughter twice and drew blood.
What? If Cesar can't find a way to help her,
Tasi!
The mayor will be forced to take action.
If I really see Tasi aggressively going after someone, she'll probably get put down.
And then, a miniature schnauzer that doesn't play well with others.
The first second she enters daycare, there's a fight breaking out.
If she gets kicked out, I don't know what I'm gonna do.
It's a doggy daycare disaster.
Evan, stop it!
This is Cesar 911. Cesar's first 911 call is from the mayor of Westlake Village, whose neighbor's dog is terrorizing his city.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Mike.
Mark.
How are you?
Is my wife gay?
Gay, nice to meet you, man.
Thank you for coming.
So how can I help you?
We're very dog friendly here. In fact, our whole street has dogs. We have our neighbors, George and Mary. They've got a dog, Tasi, and everyone can't take their dog out if Tassie's out on the street. Tasi goes after other animals, cars, and people. Mary has real difficulty holding Tasi.
Is she by herself?
No, she lives with her husband.
Husband George.
Okay, so does George participate?
He has gotten really tired of Tasi and feels that, you know, this is probably a hopeless cause. Tasi is so unpredictable. She's bit me.
Knock it off. Tasi!
She's bit my daughter twice and drew blood.
What?
Yes.
Part of the bad?
Yes.
She's very aggressive. I've got to do something.
Yeah.
And I'm the mayor, and this kind of puts me in a corner and a rock in a hard place. As mayor, part of my responsibility is the health and safety of the residents here. If I really see Tasi aggressively going after someone, we're going to have to call animal control and take her. My fear is no one's going to adopt her, and she'll probably get put down.
Yep. The mayor is definitely a dog lover, you know. Tasi beat him, beat his daughter, and then he called me and started calling animal control. If I cannot help this dog and animal control is called, she will definitely be put down.
The mayor has arranged for Mary to take Tasi on a walk by the lake so Cesar can observe Tassie's behavior.
Be careful, be careful. She's not holding the dog properly. Look at that. That's pretty bad. You need me, Mayor. We gotta come slowly. Come slowly. There you go. Meet us. That was pretty bad.
I'm Mary Thomas.
I'm George Thomas.
And we have a 4-year-old black German Shepherd. We've always had dogs.
Between our dogs, our cats, and horses, we've been an animal family, and it's been really a source of harmony.
We were probably 6 months without a dog.
About 6 months.
And I happened to be looking on Craigslist. and saw this black German Shepherd.
That was your first mistake. You don't look for dogs on Craigslist. Nothing good comes out of Craigslist. Tasi came over, and if you see her indoors, you'll find this dog that's very submissive.
Damn. Good girl.
This looks like it really is a good dog. And then we took Tasi for a walk. And this calm, nice dog suddenly exploded.
Tasi goes from zero to explosion. There's no in between.
If she would see someone riding a bike, and she would bark, and she would charge. She would jump up in the air, and she would spin in circles and almost pull you down.
I feel that each time she does that crazy behavior, I lose control of her. There's no reaching her.
There seems to be something broken in this dog, and I don't have the time or the patience to invest in trying to do something that I'm not sure is fixable.
Are you going with us?
No, I'm not going. I essentially said, Mary, she's your dog.
It's been hard on our relationship because George knows that I love Tasi, and I can't count on him to help me with the training. Tasi has bitten the mayor and his daughter. My worst fear would be the mayor of Westlake Village sees Tasi bite somebody and we would have to put her down.
That's bad, Mary.
Cesar, this is Tasi.
Yeah. Hold on, Mike, because she's hot right now.
Okay.
Look at the little one. This is definitely a tough situation, because I'm trying to control a dog that pretty much gets set up by any dog that passes by in the neighborhood. She was really out of control at that point. I want to take her for a walk first so I can calm her down.
Okay.
I'm going to go that way.
Okay.
In the meantime, you guys can chat.
Okay.
But yes, you do need help in Westlake with this dog. Jesus. I'm going that way, guys. See how she's coming down?
Wait till you see a dog.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Step by step.
Cesar arranges for another dog to stand by in order to see how Tasi reacts in a more controlled situation away from her owner.
Now we have the husky here. There you go. We removed Tasi away from the owner. Now she can look at the dog, but in a different state of mind. I had a feeling this was the case. I have to give Sassy a few corrections before she went to a lay-down, calm, submissive state. The big difference is what Tasi feels from me versus what she feels from her owner. When I first saw them, Tasi was excited and pulling Mary all over the place. But instead of correcting the behavior, Miss Mary just panicked and yanked on the leash, which only made the dog worse. All dogs need the right correction when they get out of line. Otherwise, they get confused and they continue to act out and can lead to a bite. Are you with me, Miss Mary?
I want to see Peter's dog go by.
Who's Peter's dog?
The little white one that went that way.
Even though I show Miss Mary that I can calm her dog down, she challenged me to control Tasi with her friend's dog. I'm not a magician. I'm not a circus guy. I'm a dog behaviorist. I was ready to work with Miss Mary. But if this is what it takes, so be it.
Peter's dog goes roof, 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 and she goes roof, roof, roof.
All right, once I control that, what happens to you? So once I control that, which is guaranteed.
Right.
what's going to happen to you? You become a believer?
Yeah.
Okay. Miss Mary, you're a challenge. I see what we're working with now.
Cesar agrees to Mary's challenge, so she arranges her neighbor's Maltese to walk by Cesar and Tasi to test Cesar if he can keep Tasi calm.
We're gonna control. Even an excited dog, you stay calm.
Cesar was called to help Mary with her German Shepherd, Tasi. Tasi is bitten before, and another incident could force the mayor to call animal control, where she could be removed from her owners and potentially put down. Cesar demonstrated that Tasi could be changed, but Mary was not convinced and challenges Cesar to keep Tasi calm around a neighbor's dog that has always sent Tasi into a rage.
I was doubtful of Cesar because I had seen how crazy she can be. I walk her.
Bring it back. Bring it back, sir. She has to go back. There you go. You just repeat. Took a little bit of work to correct her behavior, but actually was very easy. Every time she misbehaved, I pull on the leash to let her know that that's not what I wanted. After a bunch of repetitions, she learned. That's better. Hopefully this will open Miss Mary's eyes what's possible. So this way she learns that no matter what Toby's energy is, she has to learn to stay calm. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking she does very well with you. I'm thinking you need to take her home with you.
Maybe Miss Mary, she's not quite a believer yet.
Mary's husband, George, arrives to check on Mary and Tassie's progress.
This is being excellent. I'm being honest with you, Cesar. I told my wife she may want to find another home for the dog where they can work with her. I can't believe they're not immediately like this.
They were.
You sure that's my dog? Something remarkable happened today. When I came upon the scene and saw Cesar and saw the number of dogs and saw the number of people, I became a believer. I was wrong, and now I'm committed that I will be part of working with the dog so we can be a family.
So what do you think you have?
We have a dog. That I used to say couldn't be outdoors, and she's outdoors, and she's behaving.
But let me tell you what you have. You have an excited, anxious dog, and there is no calm, assertive leader. And that combination creates aggression. And that combination creates frustration. And that combination can also create, that's your dog, that's not my dog.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, I've
but
seen
it's not
that.
The dog. It's the way that dog is being led in the environment. Right. That's why I always say, it's not the dog, it's the human behind the dog. I wanted to show Miss Mary and George how their energy is affecting Tasi. So I hand Miss Mary the leash. Okay, Miss Mary, just stay calm. Just grab the dog, relax.
No.
Yeah.
That's mommy.
Yeah, well, that's excited source.
She saw mommy.
No, she saw excited source. Watch, pass it to me, Miss Mary. Calm. I'm taking direction. Calm. Look, I'm leading. I had Tasi in the right frame of mind, and just as I expected, when I handed the leash to Miss Mary, Tasi acted out. It's not the dog, it's how the owners handle the dog. The first thing I have to do is get them over the fears, from all the problems they had had over the years. So this is one of the dogs that I do take with me. This is the guys that, you know, she's at a level 10. We got to bring it down. So that's my suggestion for this case. I want to take Tasi to my dog psychology center and bring the owners back tomorrow for a fresh start.
The next morning, Mary and George arrive at Caesar's Dog Psychology Center to work on Tassie's rehab.
You and I, Mr. George, are going to go on a horseback ride. I decided to work with Mr. George first because he's a horseback rider, so he feels more confidence around horses. His confidence would affect Tassie's behavior. Mr. George will see what's possible and take his mind off the past. I asked Miss Mary to watch on a distance because I don't want her energy to get in the way.
Now, she's never seen horses, so...
She's never seen horses?
No.
Okay.
I'm Bodie.
The benefit of this... It's definitely, you know, to bring you back into the horse and something that you're familiar. And at the same time, to see a different behavior. She's calm.
It's calming her. Something that I would always think would make her wild is she's actually calm.
And she's off leash. She can easily take off.
Yes, which is what we always feared.
So we had an awesome horseback ride until... Miss Mary came close to the horses. No.
No, 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 no.
Miss Mary, stay back. And that when hell broke loose. Hey.
Oh.
Stay back.
Oh. Tasi, no.
Miss Mary, stay back.
Oh, oh, oh. Tasi!
Caesar needs Tassie's owners to understand how important it is to change their state of mind. He teaches George leadership skills by having Tasi follow while they ride horses and instructs Mary to keep a distance and not interfere. Tasi responds well to the exercise until Mary approaches.
No.
No, 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 no.
No. Miss Mary, stay back. No.
No, 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 no.
No.
No, no, no. Oh.
Stay back.
Oh. Tasi, no.
Miss Mary, stay back.
Oh, oh, oh. Tasi! Being on the back of a 1,200-pound animal with a dog lunging at its throat, it was a disaster waiting to happen.
Oh, oh. Tasi! Miss Mary, stay back. As soon as she got close, Tasi changed. Miss Mary, stay back.
I wonder if it's me. I really do.
See, that's what I'm saying about it. That was a scary moment. Tasi lunged at the horses. They got spooked. But Mr. George got it. He stayed calm, confident, and in control. It's definitely Miss Mary that I have to get through to. But notice that she jumped when Miss Mary came closer.
I didn't think of that. I didn't think that would be a problem.
Yep. It's definitely Miss Mary that is the issue in this relationship. George and Tasi are responding well. I want to work with Tasi on my own to see what I can get out of her, but I clearly have my work cut out when Miss Mary returns.
The next day, Caesar continues his work with Tasi without Mary or George.
So my goal yesterday was to help this family begin a new chapter in their life and for them to forget about the past. It went really good with George, but it was absolutely a disaster with Mary. I want to see what this dog can do away from Miss Mary's energy. This dog is bred to hurt sheep. Hey, the trick here is for her to hurt the sheep and not attack them. Every time she goes to bite and not to hurt, I have to correct her. Let me borrow that. If Tasi learns to hurt and not attack, it makes it very clear what I already know. This is a great dog. It just simply needs for her owners to just change. See, without Miss Mary around,
I get more control. Watch what happens when the sheep gathers and they stop. Look. See, slows down. Look, she just stopped on her own. This is what she has learned. She has learned that when the sheep stop, the game is done. She did her job. I'm done with Tasi. I did my job. Tasi is ready. Miss Mary is not ready. This is where we are. This is my dilemma right now. What are we gonna do? Tasi, what are we gonna do? She's a happy dog. I mean, this is a ranch dog. Look at that. Oh, that's a very good helper. We need that.
Mary and George return to the DPC. Cesar wants to work with Mary by having her walk Tasi next to his horse, Conquistador.
Horses are dumb, stupid animals. They are. They're dumb, stupid animals.
I know Miss Mary doesn't like horses, and she's scared of what happened the other day. Miss Mary, stay back. I want to challenge her to face her fear and ask her to walk Tasi next to a horse. We just walk, Miss Mary. Come on. I'll hold the horse. Have you seen some of my shows?
Yes.
All right. So when the owners come, that's when is the biggest problem for me.
Exactly.
Come on. She still hasn't seen that you have changed right. Yet. So but we're giving you a more manageable dog.
Right.
Not that she's completely rehabilitated, but she's more manageable.
Mary needs to walk Tasi in control next to the horse, or Tasi will continue reacting negatively to her.
This is how it's supposed to feel. Relax.
I did not know what to expect from Tasi before when she was close to the horses. She was lunging and carrying on and being crazy, and she wouldn't quit. So I was a little concerned.
It's a challenge because she has to learn to stay at a certain energy, and that takes concentration.
Right.
So obviously, you know, people get nervous and they want to quit and they want to stop and they just want to get back to safety. But that's the moment that you get to help. Now, if you don't mind, Miss Mary, I would like for you to walk with a horse. Just grab the leash.
Cesar, she can do it.
Miss Mary's pretty apprehensive about that idea.
I was really nervous, and I didn't want to do it, but George and Cesar were rooting for me.
You can do it.
Miss Mary.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. Come on, Miss Mary. There you go. Right next to it. There you go. There you go. Right. That's the feeling. Right there, Miss Mary. Can you feel it?
Yeah.
Yes. Enjoy the wind. The reason why most people move to California.
Right.
The sun. Finally, she was able to let go of her fear and just walk a dog and Tasi stay calm.
I see Tassie's potential, and that's a huge step forward.
It may seem like a small step, but it's actually a big breakthrough. Without a doubt, Miss Mary was a tough lady to work with, but at least she found her strength to face her fear and lead her dog. If she can do that at home, Tasi's gonna be way better.
George has agreed to document their progress with Tasi for Cesar to review. Will Mary become the leader Tasi needs? Or will Tasi continue to terrorize the neighborhood? Cesar's next 911 call comes from Alex, the owner of a doggy daycare facility, Canine Loft. One of his client's dogs is barking so much, it's upsetting the other dogs, and this doggy daycare owner has had enough.
Hey, man.
Hi, how you doing?
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure, what's your name?
Good to see you. Alex.
Alex.
Since obviously that I got
Thanks.
You some coffee.
Thank you.
I think it's going to be a pretty long day here, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Just to give you a rundown, you know, a little relative peace and quiet.
Yeah.
Because once every loop comes out, it's going to be very loud.
My name is Alex, and we have a very big problem with one of our clients' dogs. Abby Lou, an 8-year-old schnauzer, who comes here regularly for daycare. She has been barking nonstop in the daycare area.
The problem begins almost immediately when she walks into canine law.
Normally, it's not a big deal, but in a daycare situation, a dog that's constantly barking and create a chaotic situation with other dogs, and before you know it, there's a fight breaking out.
Abby Lou's been coming to us for just about a year. I'd say about 3 to 4 days a week.
She's a good client.
Yes, she is. I would love to have Abby Lou stay with us, but, you know, as a business owner, the health and safety of all the dogs is absolutely the number one priority. So we need to get this issue solved, or unfortunately, Abby Lou can't play at Canine Loft anymore.
In a situation like dog parks, doggy daycare centers, where dogs don't really know each other, it's the owner's responsibility to bring a dog into that scenario calmly. All right, let's get to work.
Let's go this way.
Cesar and Alex enter Canine Loft, where Cesar positions himself out of sight, where he can observe Kendra's everyday routine of dropping off Abby Lou.
Come on.
Ooh. That's bad.
Cesar observes Kendra enter the doggy daycare with her dog, Abby Lou. The owner needs Kendra to stop Abby Lou from instigating the other dogs, or he will have no choice but to kick her out of doggy daycare for good.
Come on.
Ooh. That's bad. What I got right away is the energy is bouncing from the walls and the ceiling and the floor. So this is a situation where the excitement is going to get really high.
Now that Cesar has observed Kendra's routine of dropping off Abby Lou, he needs to see Abby Lou interacting with the other dogs in the daycare area.
And now she trots around and barking away, yapping away, and in every dog's face.
Let's get Abby Lou over here. What I saw was an excited dog with an owner that she did nothing to correct the behavior. The dog was in front of her, she was barking out of control, and the owner gave her no corrections. Instead, she just gave the dog to the attendant so she can just put her with the other dogs. If a dog is excited and you don't correct it, it's going to remain excited, especially because you're going to put it around other dogs. Hi, Kendra.
Hi.
How are you?
Cesar.
Pleasure. Nice to meet
you.
Pleasure.
I was shocked to see Cesar today. I hadn't seen him beforehand. I didn't know he was going to be there. It was definitely a pleasant surprise.
You need a little help?
I do.
Yeah.
She's got some couple issues. I'm Kendra. I live in Studio City with my miniature schnauzer, Abby Lou. She's 8 years old, and I love her to death, but she barks a lot. I got Abby Lou for my 16th birthday while everyone else was getting cars. I got a puppy. Abby Lou as a puppy was super sweet. She had that high energy that all puppies have, but she was definitely more obedient
living in Wisconsin. Since having moved to LA with her, she's definitely changed completely. I noticed that Abby Lou was a lot more barky with other dogs, more aggressive, and it's very frustrating as a dog owner seeing your dog act this way. Like, I just don't know what to do. I don't. I'm a recent college grad. I've got student loans, so I'm paying that off by being a waitress. And Canine Loft is the only place that I can really afford. It really takes the pressure off of me. But Abby Lou is having behavior issues at Canine Loft. Abby has gotten warning after warning, and if she gets kicked out, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Since moving to LA, Abby is the only piece in Wisconsin that I have, and she helps me cope with the homesickness. And if I get kicked out of Canine Loft, then I might have to send her back to Wisconsin, which would be horrible.
All right, let's go for a little walk. I want you to experience what it is, a calm dog.
Okay.
You'll come back later.
Thank you.
If Kendra learned just to keep her dog calm, she will stop barking. So we need to start with the basics of leadership.
Every door is an opportunity to remind your dog that respect is important.
Okay.
So when a human goes in front, the dog will never pull human. See?
Oh, good.
Your reminder, door open doesn't mean you're running or you're pulling. It means you wait. And then you come out. It's easier to manage it. See it?
Okay, yeah.
To see Kendra's surprise by me asking her dog to wait before I bring him into another area, it lets me know that she has never understood how to lead a dog. So, what do you do for a living?
I'm a server.
Okay. There is a protocol. There is a structure that needs to happen in restaurants.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Yeah.
And so everybody in the restaurant becomes a pack, and then the manager is the pack leader. It's so important because it allows everybody to understand what's expected. Mm-hmm. So that means you receive leadership. Same thing for a dog. So for a dog to know what place you want them to walk is extremely important.
Okay.
Otherwise, they're not really understanding what's expected. They're just getting excited. So that's what leadership does. It allows people to understand expectations.
Okay. Up until today, I never thought that there were fundamentals to walking a dog. I thought just anyone could walk a dog.
The best training, the best lectures with a dog is actually in the outside world.
Uh-huh.
Right now, what I want to do for you is for you to learn how to walk a pack of dogs. Most people should learn how to walk a pack of dogs, not one dog.
Okay.
Because then they focus in the pack, not one dog. I want Kendra to begin with a pack walk. You know, she reminds me a lot of people I meet. Her dog is not a hard case. I want her to understand the fundamentals of pack leadership. Once she learns to become a pack leader, all Abby Lou's problems, even her barking, will go away. Most important is, look, you're feeling calmness and you're feeling confident.
And if one tries to get ahead, you just kind of pull them back?
You block them, it's like right there.
Yep.
Yeah. Hey.
Just with a noise and a snap.
No, it's the energy and then it's the noise. Because you can do the thing, but if you don't have the energy, if they don't take you serious, it doesn't matter what you say.
It was kind of an eye-opening experience when Cesar told me that dogs can read our energies, and the kind of energy that you give off and your dog gives off can affect a pack of dogs.
Here. Your turn.
Okay.
Yeah, you can do it.
I know. Go. And I know, no tension.
Sure, but not tense. Here, but you need the whole pack.
Oh, I'm taking everybody.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
It's a pack walk.
Next thing you know, Caesar's having me walk his pack with Abby Lou. And I was really nervous.
it's hard for you to send or to ask for them to adjust because you're still tense.
Mm-hmm. I know, I'm sorry.
No, don't worry, don't apologize.
I'm trying to detense and calm down.
Kendra must master this basic skill if she has any chance of keeping her dog at daycare.
Let me just regroup.
Cesar works with Kendra by taking her on a pack walk. Kendra must build her skills as pack leader if she wants to turn around Ebby Lou's behavior and be welcome back at doggy daycare.
Let me just regroup.
I'll do it again.
Okay, see, thank see. You.
Let's do it again.
Oh, boy.
Bring it.
Ebby, shh.
There you go. Bring it. Yeah, keep going. This is when you get to work, girl. There you go. Right there. Kendra was thinking too much, and her nerves was affecting her pack walk. It's definitely one of my biggest challenges to stop human thinking too much and just do it. So you don't have to think walking dog. You can just think football.
Well, I used to actually want to be a field reporter for ESPN.
Oh, there you go.
To cover what? My Packers.
Really? Yeah. I should have brought my shirt for the Packers.
Oh, are you a fan?
Yeah.
Shut the front door.
Shut the front door. At one point, I mentioned the Packers, which is from Wisconsin, and the biggest pride of her life came out. And we were not walking dogs anymore. We were talking about the Packers. There you go, right there. You're in the zone.
I know.
You're in the zone, girl. That's what I wanted to bring out. So you didn't see a shy girl. You didn't see a hesitant girl. She got it. She walked 6 dogs, 1 hand.
So cool.
You're doing it. There we go. Beautiful.
I can't believe I did it. Like, I got to walk all those dogs, and they all stayed in line. You know, even my dog. Like, it was so empowering.
Okay, so you did really good on the pack walk. Energy is good.
Okay.
Right? You adjust very well. But now I want to see you going inside the canine loft.
Okay.
Cesar challenges Kendra to repeat a routine of dropping off Ebby Lou at daycare. When Kendra dropped her off earlier, she acted out by barking. This time, Kendra must hand over a calm Ebby Lou that does not bark, or the owner will not allow Ebby Lou at his daycare.
Be the pack leader.
For daycare. Oh, hey.
I can tell as soon as Kendra entered the door that she forgot the fundamentals of her lesson. She let Ebby Lou enter the door and gave the dog to the attendants, even though she was excited. At that point, we were done. We went back to the beginning. So, Alex, what do you think?
To be honest with you, I'm not fully convinced yet, Cesar.
It's pretty disappointing, but I really can't argue with Alex. I just hope I can get Ebby Lou to where she needs to be so she can stay at Canine Loft.
In order for us to achieve what he wants, we need to make sure we work on the walk. You know, we need to make sure we work on the excitement and the thresholds, the doors. We're going to put some surveillance cameras so we can see the video together.
Okay.
Right?
Good.
So we're in the right track. I wasn't surprised that Kendra faltered. She was put on the spot, and she forgot all the key points I taught her. I'm glad that she got to see the bad results, because that only gonna make her practice even harder. I have a lot of faith in her. We'll see you next time.
Okay, bye.
Thank you.
Cesar uses surveillance cameras to monitor Kendra's progress. Will she be able to keep Abby Lou in a calm state so that she's welcome back at doggy daycare? Or will Abby Lou be kicked out and sent back to Wisconsin? After 2 weeks of working with Tasi on their own, Cesar meets with Mary and George to review the footage that George filmed of their progress.
Well, we miss you, Tasi. You want to sit down?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. I was originally called by the mayor because Tasi was out of control and she has bit some of the neighbors. It was definitely Miss Mary's energy that was affecting Tasi, and it took a lot of work for me to get through to her.
Tasi, no.
Miss Mary, stay back. I hope her and Mr. George take what they learned and make some progress on their own.
Let me see what you, the surveillance said, because I haven't seen it, so I want to see it in action.
Okay.
I love the way you started, Miss Mary.
Yes.
Better, better.
That tail right there is perfect. Wagging tail in the middle is perfect. You're definitely a dog walker now.
To be honest, I did a lot of soul searching after we left Cesar. I realized I had to face my fears and start fresh to be a strong pack leader for Tasi.
Yeah, I love how calm you stay throughout the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Stature is awesome. Your calmness is awesome. Commanding is awesome. So you pass by dogs or you don't pass by dogs, or there's no dogs when you are walking around dogs?
Yeah. We're getting there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have a plan.
Right.
And you have a goal.
Right.
So you have the plan and then you have the goal. And now you're just developing the skills. It's a work in progress, but she's definitely changed her energy. I can see her now walking calmly and having confidence. I have to say, I'm impressed. Ooh, Miss Mary,
yes.
You get a hug.
Tasi is not fixed 100%. She's an animal, but I feel much more confident being able to nip it in the butt before it gets carried away.
It's drastically, dramatically from what I saw the first time. Yeah? Don't you agree? I love it. I really love it.
This has been a fascinating journey. He's taught us what we need to learn about ourselves and how we need to apply what he's taught us to working with the dog.
I'm definitely glad the mayor called Cesar to help us.
How are you guys?
We're doing good.
Hi, hello. Mr. Mayor. How are you?
Oh, hi, Mary.
How are you? Hey, Jay. Hey, how are you?
Hi.
Oh.
Wow.
Now that's what I call respect for the mayor.
There you go. I was amazed at how calm Tasi was. I mean, it was a totally different dog. I'm actually looking forward to seeing Mary later this week or whatever, walking Tasi outside, and I'm going to go out and get the newspaper and be neighborly, like we like on our street.
Junior, come here. See, that's her best pal. There you go.
Yeah.
I was not feeling Miss Mary in the beginning, I tell you the truth. She was challenged because she wanted to learn. I just didn't know that's what she wanted. You know, I feel more like she was challenging me. But Miss Mary stepped up to the plate, and I love what I see. I'm very happy. I'm very proud of her. I think Tasi is definitely and the right track to becoming the greatest citizen Westlake has. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You did great things.
It made me so proud. Oh. Thank you. I got the leash, man.
All right.
All right, Cesar.
A week has passed, and Cesar is ready to see if Kendra has been able to maintain Eddie Lou in a calm state by being a stronger pack leader. He arranges to meet her outside of doggy daycare.
Hey, Cesar.
Hi.
You look happy.
I am happy.
That's fantastic.
Yeah,
good to hear
what's
it.
What's going on?
Good, good.
Since last time I saw Cesar, I've been working very hard, doing everything he told me to do, and I'm hoping it pays off when we go inside K9 Loft.
All right, so let's go. I want to see the surveillance camera that we put. Yeah.
Okay.
See how you did?
Yeah, let's check this out.
Have you seen it?
No.
Oh, okay, well, we're going to see it together.
Good things, I hope.
Yes. I was called to help Kendra because Abby Lou's barking was upsetting the doggy daycare, and they were at the verge to be kicked out. We worked with Kendra on her leadership, making sure Abby Lou was calm before she hands her over to the daycare. Hopefully she kept at it so Abby Lou can stay at the daycare center rather to be sent to Wisconsin. This is the threshold.
Okay.
Okay. One of the basic things we worked on is making sure Abby Lou goes into a calm state. Kendra leads her into a new environment rather than the other way around. So here's Abby Lou. I like it.
Yeah.
Settle down. No hesitation. Love it. That's a good threshold. Before the door. I'm glad you're remembering, because that door means the same thing as this door. Mm-hmm. Every door is the same door. The other part of Kendra's homework is making sure Abby Lou's walk with her in a consummate state, either beside her or behind her. The hallway. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Just the energy alone. Awesome. Look at you. Just so consistent, your energy. You know, it's so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Look at her. She's so proud of herself because she's listening to you.
She's so happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So today is the final test.
Okay.
Let's show Alex that Abby Lou can definitely stay here.
We'll pass with flying colors.
Yes! I love that confidence.
Now Cesar puts Kendra to the final test. Kendra needs to prove she can deliver a well-behaved dog to daycare, or she will be kicked out for good, and Abby Lou will be sent back to Wisconsin. Cesar is pleased with Kendra and Abby Lou's progress. But now comes the final test. If Kendra can't prove that Abby Lou can stop barking and behave at daycare, they will be kicked out, and Kendra will be forced to send Abby Lou back to Wisconsin.
Take your time.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
Take your time. So she's following, you're in front. Hello, she's not excited, she's not pulling.
Yes.
Very good.
Go. Wait.
Very good. Go. You love that sound.
It's fun.
I know, right?
Go. Daycare.
Nice.
The real test is whether or not Abby Lou will revert to her old barking behavior when reintroduced to the other dogs.
Very good.
It's precious.
Love it. Look at that. Very good. That was awesome. Oh, yeah. This was like a whole different Kendra and Abby Lou. Last time we came here, Kendra had no control and Abby Lou was barking and upsetting the whole entire daycare. Now, Kendra walks in correctly and Abby Lou follows her in a calm, submissive state. Kendra handed over the leash while Abby Lou was in the right state and she stayed calm and didn't bark.
Very good.
Alex, how are you?
Hi, how you doing?
Really good, my man.
Good to see you, Cesar.
Good to see you,
How's
man.
How's everything?
Always wearing the K9 Loft shirt,
of course.
As it should. So,
What do you think?
I'm actually happy to say that it looks like things are going really well.
Oh, fantastic.
I was just watching right now.
Yeah.
She went in there nice and quiet, yeah. No problems, and there's no chaos back
yeah.
there. And that's exactly where we need things yeah. to be. So.
So we can stay?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely, yes. High five. High five. Yeah. Come on, guys. That's a good
awesome.
One. Great.
I am very happy I called Cesar. It was an amazing transformation, and thanks to Cesar, Abilu gets to stay. You know, I think it's fantastic. All the work you've done really paid off.
I didn't do anything. My girl did.
So some yeah. guidance, some much needed guidance.
Bit.
This whole process is just, it's incredible. Cesar's methods work. He's changed so much with me and my dog, and he's also just really changed my outlook as a person, and it's crazy. It's just I'm so blown away.
Thank you for giving us
thank you for
this
coming.
Opportunity.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you
really
so much.
Thank you so much.
One more hug for my girl. It is an amazing feeling to see a young lady switch drastically, because before she was absorbing and not knowing and worried, and now you can see her stature is bigger. Her happiness is there, her joy, her calmness. There's a lot of these layers that I got to experience with Kendra in such a short period of time.
Congratulations.
Oh, thanks, sir.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye, Cesar.
Bye, guys. Thank you. It's definitely a privilege to see two people and two dogs drastically transforming right in front of my eyes. I had a hard time with Miss Mary, but she definitely faced her fear and she found a way to control her dog, Tasi. Kendra, she just needed to be educated. Once I taught her the basics of pack leadership, she had the confidence to work on her own and completely change Abby Lou. They're two different people, but that just goes to show that when a person is willing to change, the dog will follow.